and on being a part of this film. You think about things that you want to do as a kid, like, oh, I want to fly a plane, I want to grow up to be a doctor, I want to go to space. And for actors, George Lucas is that metaphor for space. Like, he is it. And, you know, so all of the cast, we're in space right now. We're on planet George, and it's incredible. I feel good. I feel very Tuskegee Airman right now.
In order to do it or to know it, you have to go through it. I flew, and I mandated that all the cast get flown.
I tried to hype myself up. I'm like, yeah, let's go. Let's go. Woo. Woo. I got so much respect for anybody who has ever sat in one of those and did anything for our country. Anthony, you said all the time that this is way bigger than you. Right now, I understand what you're talking about. I didn't feel validated in our performances until the airman came.
Oh, God.
How you doing, sir?
Yeah.
Good. Hey, good to see you. They're seeing it firsthand, and they're looking at it, they're getting goosebumps, and they're saying, oh, yeah, that's right. That's what we did. Because believe me, they said otherwise. You got to hear them critique the plane landings. It was a three-wheel landing, and the back wheel kind of hit and skipped.
He ran it in on two wheels. Instead of dropping it in.
And I'm like, wow. He is like close to 90 years old and still talking trash.
Look, I don't like being called Junior. I want the tag Ray Gun. I'm not a kid.
I knew Tristan was gonna be a big star.
I'm good enough to keep right on your tail.
He's someone that I met early in his career on The Wire. He was 15, 16 years old.
He's a guy who loves to fly. There's nothing else that he'd rather do.
So you know the timing on action, you're looking at your leader, yeah. Right?
Honestly, I admire Ray, which is why I'm so happy I get to play him.
The sky's blue and my guns are hot.
He's a guy with an immense amount of strength and courage.
Can't really see you guys right now. I just hope I'm looking at the camera.
Although he does have these injuries, he still wants to get up there and prove himself. In the movie, I did a parachuting scene.
The funny thing is, they had a stunt double for me. But, you know, I'm thinking, this I could do this. You know, this would be cool. Kids, don't try this at home.
3, 2, 1, go!
Anthony is like the big brother. Just to make sure that it's safe, he went up and did it too. He didn't have to do it. He's a director, but he did. And I love him 20 times more for that.
I'm going ahead.
I'm always up for a challenge.
Yeah. Ray Gun strikes again.
How you guys doing? My name is Michael B. Jordan. I'm playing Maurice.
Michael and I met on The Wire.
Flight officer Maurice Wilson, sir.
I actually got to tell him he got the part myself. To see his face light up, he just completely started bawling. And I was like, all right, you gotta stop, because I'm gonna start crying.
Haha, watch out, here we come.
Maurice is a new recruit. You know, he's fresh out of flight school.
Flight officer Maurice Wilson, sir.
And he's eager to prove himself, eager to be a man, eager just to prove himself as a fighter pilot.
I don't wanna learn how to play cards. I wanna learn about combat flying.
We are in Prague right now. It is freezing.
Like, oh my God, what have I gotten myself into? But you know what? I'm ready.
You know, George Lucas has been wanting to do a film about the Tuskegee Airmen for a couple decades now. And the fact that, you know, we have a black president, a military, and there's just so much going on, it seems like it's the perfect time to shed light on this story.
Get your head up, son. You're fighter pilots.
There's not too many Tuskegee Airmen left alive, and it's an honor and a privilege just to portray their characters and tell their story.
How you doing?
To go and talk to them, like, hey, did you guys say this, or would you have done this in this situation? And they would tell you right then and there.
If you're coming in low like that, you break away and they can't follow you.
They were definitely an amazing help because they gave us that authenticity.
You're an airman, you're a pilot. What the hell are you doing out here with a rifle?
And they put their stamp of approval on us. They would tell us all the time, like, you actually look like us. You look like me back in the day. And I was like, you know what? To hear an actual Tuskegee Airman, the person that you're portraying, tell you that you remind them of themselves is a huge compliment.
Like angels. I don't know any angels with 650 caliber machine guns.
And it's
this is like a dream come true, man. Coming from Newark, New Jersey, never would have done this before. Man. Mind blowing, dude. I have so much respect for pilots, man. It's a beautiful machine.
The Tuskegee Airmen had to fight against two fronts, one against the Nazis during the war, but also once again once they came back to the United States in the segregated country. So we needed a great villain. If anybody has seen Breaking Bad, you realize what an extraordinary person Bryan Cranston is, because he's bad, but he's also good, and we needed him to be bad in this, and he came in and just in 2 days did the part. It was a real gift for us. We couldn't be more grateful that he joined our cast.
My name is Bryan Cranston. I'm playing the role of Colonel William Mortimus in the film Red Tails. He is the villain of the piece, but certainly you don't approach a character that way. You try to find the honest truth about what he believes and present that.
I don't believe your boys have scored a single aerial kill.
Because you have not assigned us a single forward mission.
The scene we're shooting today is where we start to understand the attitude that was present in the early 40s and that there was a definite segregation to the army.
You're colored men in a white man's army. It's a miracle you're flying fighters in Italy.
What we have to do, Anthony Hemingway, our director, has to transport a modern day audience back to those years and the feeling apparent in those days of race relations.
What are you doing here? This is an officer's club.
I am an officer.
This is a whites only officer's club.
We will not go away.
And Terrence is so good, I almost don't want to look at him because of his stare.
Now, we've done every low-down, dirty job you've handed us.
And that sort of worked for me. I would turn away, and it's almost even more dismissive if I don't even acknowledge your presence there.
And I'm afraid you're just going to have to suffer its failure.
Despite how I feel personally, it doesn't diminish my interest in playing a character that's far less than perfect. They're really the best roles. To play someone with a point of view that's so askew, they're delicious.
Still doesn't change what I think of you and your boys.
We don't care.
In the 70s, my father was producing a movie, and it was the story of the Tuskegee Airmen during World War II. And there was someone at the studio who, after 3 weeks of production, pulled the plug and said, we just can't put this much money behind a black movie. And it shut down the whole picture, and it went away. That wasn't that long ago. So for me, being able to be in a picture that will come to completion because of George Lucas, it gives me satisfaction to know that I'm, in a small way, contributing to the completion of the story. And hopefully the role, it'll come off believable, and I'll be booed.
They done shot down the whole Luftwaffe, didn't they?
Yes, they did, huh? Those hot shots sure did.
Hi, this is Method Man Clifford Smith. My character's name is Sticks, and this is Red Tails.
Dad, Mom, I have a job. I'll be moving out your basement in no time.
You got three planes? The hydraulic pumps are shot. Two more got back
up. Grab a piece of that tape and put it over that hose.
Crewmen, they were as important as the pilots. The pilots had to go out and do the missions and complete the missions, but they couldn't do it without our babies, which are the planes.
What the hell is this? Did somebody throw a train at you?
Coffee, I can see you upset.
The crewmen became very attached to these vehicles.
I can tolerate the P-40s. But these new babies getting beat up, it breaks my heart.
The same affection that they have for the plane, they would have for their pilots. You're praying that the plane makes it back in one piece, as well as your pilot. You have to look at these men, look at the adversity that they had to deal with, and really applaud their efforts. I mean, this is beyond having Michael Jordan as a hero. This is beyond thinking Derek Jeter is a god on the baseball field. My accomplishments are nothing compared to anything these guys have done. Whatever black pride we have, it's going to increase even more.
Get your head up, son. You're fighter pilots.
Bright red tails, black pilots, you can't call us nothing else but distinctive.